Hi everyone, I'm Roger Carp. I'm senior editor at Classic Toy Trains magazine, and I'm here today to talk about bees. Bees were not exactly the grades we wanted to get, but bee movies could be so bad they were good. And the B-sides of 45s could really be great. In fact, I think my favorite B-side was the Everly Brothers. The A-side was All I Won't Have to Do Is Dream, which was number one in 1958. That was good. That was good for slow dancing. But the B-side was Claudette, which Roy Orbison wrote and the Everlys recorded, and that was a really good rocker for dancing. But the bees I do want to talk about today, as much as I do love to talk about oldies, these are the bee units. The bee units that Lionel created for its post-war train line. In 1948, Lionel cataloged its first F3s, New York Central and Santa Fe. With the powered unit, there was an unpowered A unit. It looked better that way, and so they were able to sell the combination. 2 years later, in 1950, Lionel introduced an unpowered B unit, which, and I'm going to hold up one right now. This is the early New York Central. It was number 2344C. If you turn this one upside down, you will see that number rubber stamped right there. Now, if you're a collector, as nice as this one might be, you're noticing some flaws with it right away. I have to admit, you're right. The one that I own does not have the clear plastic portholes. Those often fall out, and believe me, I will find correct replacements, so I hope you'll bear with me. What makes this one neat for me is this is the early one, and the early B units, you tell them, because on the roof, they have these two wide areas that have wire cloth coverings. Okay, the wire cloth covers are there, and that's a key identifying trait for the early Santa Fe and early New York Central B units. The B units were introduced in the 1950 consumer catalog. Right here in the bottom of page 26. And the copy read, B units for Santa Fe and New York Central diesels. You asked for them. Here they are. Okay, I guess people did ask for them. I'll take Lionel at their word for that. And these were available for $11.95 each. The later B units changed the roof. And you can see it's different. There's no longer a wire cloth covering the holes, but instead they're open. So the B units changed, and look what else on this Illinois Central from the mid-50s. The portholes have been filled in. Pretty nice looking model to go with your Illinois Central A unit. This is the black lettered version. The earlier one is introduced was brown lettering. This is the black one. That's something important to notice. And let me conclude by asking a little trivia question for all of you out there. Lionel created 12 different road names for its F3s between 1948 and 1958. How many different B units? How many of them had B units? So now you're thinking, I'm going to tell you the answer. The only two road names that did not were the Western Pacific and the Canadian Pacific. All the other ones did have B units. So thanks so much. Great to talk with you. I hope I got an A today in your minds talking about B units.
Roger Carp is a nationally known toy train historian. Read his articles in every issue of Classic Toy Trains magazine. Subscribe today by going to classictoytrains.com/sub. Thanks for watching.